Let's see some of the important questions from sexual reproduction in flowering plants. To the biologist, the flowers are morphological marvels, embryological marvels. Both will be considered by the biologist. So, both A and B is the answer. Next, a typical angiosperm anther is. The typical angiosperm anther is bilobed and dithecous. That is the answer. So, each anther will have two lobes. And each lobe will have dithecous. So, thecus, which is a reproductive tissue which undergoes the meiosis. Next, the anther is four-sided structure, consists of four microsporangia. This is the answer. So, we'll have four microsporangia. So, bilobed and dithecous. Bilobed means two lobes, for each lobe will have two thecus. So, totally four microsporangia. The microsporangia develop further and become. So, the microsporangia will develop and further become pollen sacs. So, the answer is pollen sac. The pollen grain represents the male gametophytes. Embryo sac is represented by female gametophytes. So, the answer is male gametophyte. The hard outer layer of pollen grain called exyme, and it is made up of sporopollenin. This is present especially in the pollen grains only. Sporopollenin is the answer. Pollen grains are well preserved as fossils because of the presence of, so the same structure, sporopollenin. Next, which of the following has been climbed to increase the performance of athletes and race horses? That is other than pollens. Pollens are climbed to increase the performance in both athletes as well as horses. Pollen grains lose their viability within 30 minutes of their release in some of the cereals like rice and wheat. So, only it has a time of 30 minutes. Rising from the placenta are the megasporangia, commonly called. So, we commonly call from the placenta is ovules. So, the answer is ovules. So, the megasporangia is ovule. Next. Opposite the micropylar end represents the basal part of the ovule, which we call it as chalazal end. Chalaza means knot. It looks like a knot. So, opposite to the micropylar end will have the chalazal end. So, these are some of the questions for the sexual reproduction in flowering plants.